Hello and welcome. Let's start using the Olive Video Editor. It is still heavy in development, so new features are coming on a weekly basis, so make sure to subscribe so you see the newest videos as they come out. Bookmark this video with Ctrl D so you can come back when you forget something. And once you did that, let's start. We're gonna start by importing some clips. To do so, I can simply select multiple files and drag them into this area. This is the project window. I'm just gonna hide this title using window lock panels so we have more space. I'm also gonna import one image file and one audio file. You can start by simply dragging these clips from the project area into the timeline down here. And once you release, a new sequence is created based on the clip that you drag in. If you right-click on the clip, go to Properties, you can see this is 1280 by 720 at 23 frames per second. And if you right-click on Sequence and go to Properties, you can see the same values, except the frame rate is different. That's interesting. So, might be a smart choice to double-check here. Let's drag in this one. And this one is actually bigger. So let's modify the sequence. Go to Properties, we're going to set this to 1080. And let's compare. This is 29.97, okay. So we're going to base this on this clip. And now the positions are weird, so we can just click on the clips and right-click position in this area and reset to default. And we can do the same over here, reset to default. Now to scale this one up, we're just going to set scale to 150 here. Let me just type it in. And now we can start editing. By default, there is a cut between these two. It just switches to the next one. And we can add transition to this using the transition tool, for example. We can press T or click this icon and then pick cross dissolve. That's the only transition for video currently available. There's free transitions for audio. Let's pick cross dissolve and we can click in the middle. And we should be able to drag to the left and right, but we cannot because currently there are no extra frames available. We would have to first cut part of a video. So we can do the following. We can instead fade to black or to the background by moving the cursor to the left. And then clicking and dragging a little, and this is now crossfade to black. And we can do the same on the right hand side. We just move from the center to the right of the cut, and we click and drag and release. And now it's to black and from black. So that's one solution. I'm just going to Control Z this. And instead we're going to make room for a crossfade. So we're going to press Q while the playhead is over here. It will remove this area, Q. There we go. And I'm going to do the same on the left side. Pressing W. Alright, now we have extra frames and we can click and hold. And this is now a crossfade. As you can see, it changes from one video to the other directly. And here it goes. Alright, I'm going to press V to return to the normal select tool. And I can resize this by dragging the border of this crossfade. So it'll be a faster crossfade now. There is currently a bug where the image of the second video stays during the crossfade, but that'll be fixed soon, I'm sure. By the way, these title or safety lines you can see here I enabled using View, Title, Action, Save Area, and then 16 by 9. I can also turn them off. You can also cut in other ways. Let me just add an image, for example. I'm going to extend this. You can use the razor tool by pressing C and then just clicking to cut. And then you can click on the pieces. First somewhere else, then on the pieces, and press the delete key on the keyboard to delete them. You can also do most stuff from the context menu by right-clicking. For example, delete or copy, or ripple delete, which will delete it but also move everything where it was. Just gonna undo that. And now I'm gonna add this clip as well. I will also ripple delete this empty space here. And let's make a fade between these two, but first I'm gonna cut off this part. I'm gonna use the razor tool for this. I'm gonna click here, press V to go to back to the default select tool, click here, and delete. And delete the empty space. I could have done this quicker by right-clicking and then ripple deleting. If you have multiple clips stacked on top of each other, you can use, for example, this edit tool by pressing X and then selecting an area. And then you can delete multiple clips at the same time. So by pressing the delete key on the keyboard, you just delete. By pressing Shift-Delete, you ripple-delete. The same is true for selecting clips. This is Delete, and this is Shift-Delete. And I'm gonna delete this empty space as well. I'm just going to add a transition here, cross-dissolve, and now let's look and listen to this piece. So this video clip comes with audio, which is abruptly starting. Let's add an audio transition here. So we're going to click the transition button and pick an exponential fade. And I'm going to just click and drag here as well. Let's take a look and a listen. Much nicer. Now let's add some music. We're just going to drag this audio file to a new audio track down here. I'm going to zoom out and I'm going to press C, cut it over here. V, I'm going to drag this over here and delete this part. Let's zoom back in. I'm using Control Mouse Wheel for that. Alright, I do not like this music anymore, I'm gonna remove this. We could also just cut the music track here, and then we would kind of switch from this track to this one. We could also add a transition here. Let me just add another exponential fade here. But as you can see or hear, it first turns to silence and then turns back to the music. So we could also make a crossfade. For that, I'm just going to press V, I'm going to select this transition, delete it, click this one, delete it with the delete key, and I'm going to drag this clip down here, and I'm going to press T, exponential fade, and click here and drag, and now we have a transition between these two music tracks. Let's listen in. And I just added an outro, kind of. So that works, but I want to completely replace all the audio with this track. So I'm going to delete these transitions again. And I'm going to delete this clip. But if I hit delete now, it deletes the video and the audio. So I'm just going to undo that, and instead I'm going to right-click it and press link unlink. I can also hit Control L for that. Now they are separate. I'm going to click somewhere else, and now click on the audio and just delete it. I'm going to expand this audio down here, the audio file, and just going to listen to that. All right. There we go. You know what, I want to also add a kind of logo, so I'm going to drag in another image, which is not scaled or edited to match the screen or the video. As you can see, it's too big and right into your face. So we're going to scale it down right there, and we're going to position it by using actually this. We're going to just click and drag. Not going to click and drag the center because that changes the anchor point over here. Let's reset that. Instead, we're going to click on the area outside of the center. I'm going to put it over here, bottom left. And I will also reduce the opacity to, let's say, 75. Let's extend it to the whole track. All right, so that's how easy you can add an overlay. All right, so now we're going to add some titles. Let's press this icon right here, add title, solid, bars, etc. And select title. And now we have to draw a clip, so to speak. Let's just start at the beginning and draw it until this. This now is a title with the sample text sample text. If we click it, we can modify it. I'm going to make transform small. We're going to keep it in the center for now. Let's replace this with tux is worth a sub. And we can press edit text to change the font and the style and the size. We can drag this simply. Let's go for 90. And OK. And we can control the position over here. Let's drag it a little down. Gonna check it in this. I think the position is OK here as well. And we can do other things, like, for example, add a shadow. Let's enable the shadow with this checkbox. Let's set the distance to a little bit more than default. And the angle should be 45, I believe. around that and make it a bit softer, blurry. Let's take a look. Yeah, I like that. So now we are also going to add keyframes to it to animate it. We can keyframe pretty much anything by using the transform position values, but I'm going to use the rich text position values here. So at the beginning, it's supposed to start outside of the frame. So we're going to click on this clock icon over here. This enables keyframes, and I'm going to drag this to the left. I want it to come into the screen from the left. Now I'm going to advance on the timeline for about 15 frames, about half a second. I used the arrow keys just now to move precisely. And here I want it to return to zero. So I can just click and type in zero and enter. And let's take a look at this. All right. And we're going to do the same at the end, a bit slower, and it's going to move downward. So let's add a keyframe here. Okay, and let's move to the end. We can use the arrow down key for that and then go left one frame. And we're going to change the Y value or the vertical position value. So yeah, it's supposed to go down. So let's do it like this. And a new keyframe has been added automatically. Let's take a look at the end result. All we gotta do now is export the video. We go to File, Export, or hit Ctrl-M. And here we can pick the format, and I just recommend MPEG-4 unless you have specific needs. And entire sequence is the default, but if you set in and out point by hitting I and O, then that area will be exported. But let's go back to File, Export, and when you open this menu, make sure that you are aware of the range being automatically set to in and out if you have in and out. So make sure to change it to entire sequence if that's what you want. The codec, the default codec of MPEG-4 video is fine. So you should just leave it at libx264. You can double check width, height, and frame rate, but they should match the sequence. And now one thing you should definitely take a look at is the quality CRF value. If you hover your mouse over it, you can see that 0 is lossless, which I do not recommend. And 51 is low quality. And the default is always 36, even if I set this to, let's say, 19, and I cancel this. If I open export window again, first of all, in to out has been reset, and quality has been reset. This can be a problem. I recommend you use at least 23. That is what the Olive team claims is high quality. I usually use 20 or even 15, but I think 20 might be enough. If you use 36, you can tell how bad transitions, for example, are. If you don't want audio in your video at all, you can simply uncheck it here. And by the way, we still have these two empty audio clips. They don't hurt, but just to be safe, let's just click on them, hit Ctrl-L to unlink them. And again here, and we're going to just right-click and disable these. But they can stay on the timeline. All right, back to export, back to setting this to entire sequence, and setting this to 20. And now we just hit export, and now we have to pick the folder where we export to, and you have to give it a file name. And then you just hit the save button, and it starts exporting. You have to wait for this progress bar to finish before you can access the video, so don't start uploading it yet. Write a comment if this video was useful or if you have any question about using Olive. Alright, here is the file. Let's take a look. Have fun editing videos, and I will see you next time. Until then, ciao!